I decided this video was serious enough to not wait for my usual posting time because apparently 4,000 plus people have downloaded malware without knowing it, and if you're one of those people, you probably want to know right away, and also a warning for additional people. So for context, I got an email today from someone saying that Sabrent, a very popular device manufacturer, which I actually own several of their products, on their official website, in their download section, they have malware impostering as legitimate firmware updates. And my first reaction was, okay, this is probably just someone overreacting to like a false positive. But after looking into it myself, yeah, it seems pretty obvious that that is the case. It's true. And we'll take a look at the actual files and stuff in the video later. Obviously, to be clear though, I'm sure that this is not intentional from Sabrent. And once they become aware of these files, they will delete them. So first of all, before I go any further, I can give you specifically what to watch out for. It seems that the ones I found, the malicious files, are in the downloads for firmware updates for these two devices, the HBBUP7 and HBBU10, and I believe these are two USB hubs. Potentially there could be more, but those are just the ones that I happen to see. But let me back things up because you're probably wondering why I think this and what evidence do I have. So it turns out someone noticed malware on Sabrent's website on April 14th, so almost a month ago, and they posted on Reddit saying Sabrent hosting malware, and they talked about how a firmware update for their device, which was different, the HBB7C3, when you went to download it, it downloaded a RAR file despite the download page saying it would be a zip file. That was like a first red flag, and that it actually contained a RAT, a remote access Trojan, and indeed when they scanned the file on VirusTotal, overwhelmingly positive results for malware. Now, to Sabrent's credit, they did respond to that thread within about 6 hours, saying that they are at least aware of it, and the representative wasn't sure why the file had not been taken down. He then followed up saying, without going into too much detail, I had previously spoken with the source factory for this hardware and firmware and had been assured it was safe. I then spoke to multiple people about it who agreed that it should be removed. And so regardless if it's safe or not, it needs to go. I'm targeting it now. So they did indeed look into it and said that later on, the file should now no longer be available in any way. Thank you for your patience, blah, blah, blah. So it seems like they really did make an effort, but they just were not aware that it's still up elsewhere multiple times. You can see that one user replied 10 days ago, about 2 weeks after the original thread, saying that another product they noticed, the HBBUP7, has the same issue, and that Sabrent support had actually told them that it was a false positive. And actually, this BUP7 one is the same one that this person who emailed me was talking about this morning. So let's go actually take a look. If you go on Sabrent's download page and search for BUP7, you can see that there is an update called HBBUP7 firmware update with around 2,400 downloads. And just like it was reported in that Reddit thread for the other one, the page says that the file should be a zip file, but when you go to download it, it's actually a RAR file with a different name. That's suspicious. And you even get a browser warning about it being malicious. That's a bigger red flag still. And I am using a virtual machine for all this, by the way. Do not download this yourself. Now, before even looking inside the archive, I uploaded it to VirusTotal. And guess what? Looking at the hash, it's actually the exact same archive that the person on Reddit had talked about, because they linked to their scan of the VirusTotal one, and it's the same thing. If we look into the extracted archive, there's some bin files and a Word document that we'll come back to, it is relevant. And if we go further in, we find this folder. It contains some EXEs and DLLs, but right here is the file in question, which is rhc.exe. Now, as you'll see, it seems that the three DLLs and the cache rhc.exe are actually the legitimate original updates, and I'll show you how I know that, and that the rhc.exe is the malicious imposter, along with this config file too. First of all, if we upload the rhc.exe directly to VirusTotal individually, just like the archive as a whole, it lights up like a Christmas tree for positive malicious results. On the other hand, if we do the same thing with the cache rhc file, it comes up clean, but in addition to that, if we look at the property tabs for both of these executables, you can see that the cache RHC file is properly signed by Realtek with a trusted certificate, while the rhc.exe one is not. And the fact that it claims to be a driver file, not that it's actually a driver, but the fact that it claims to be one and it's unsigned, yeah, giga red flag. I can elaborate on that later though. Anyway, if we look at the DLL files, those are also signed, so I believe that those are the originals, and then this RHC one is the imposter. Now, why include the original along with the imposter one? Well, I would bet anything that the strategy is to get the user to click the RHC one, the malicious one, and not that scary-looking cache, EXE, and then that unloads the payload, the malicious payload, and then after it infects you, it then goes and runs the legitimate installer so that it does actually go and install the update after you're infected, so the user thinks, oh, well, my device works now, it didn't before, it must have worked, so it must have been legit, but really it just infected you and installed the update. And no, I am not going to be running this even inside the virtual machine. Next, if we look in this config file, there's also something suspicious about it. These paths right here, I'm not really sure what they're for, but it's hard-coded to put files into a new directory called 123123 user directory, and this weird folder of Unicode characters doesn't seem legit to me. Turns out that these are actually Chinese characters. You'll see that later though. If I had to guess, the config file is probably loaded by the legitimate EXE, and the malicious people probably modified it to their own ends for some reason. You can see that the legitimate EXE was renamed around the same time as the config file, so that's probably when they added in their own malicious stuff when they changed the legitimate ones. That also clued me in on that Word document file, but I'll come back to that in a minute. Now, after seeing all this myself and, yeah, being thoroughly convinced that it's malicious, I wondered, is this on other product pages? Are other ones affected too? So I went on the download page for listing all the downloads on their site and sorted by date and looked to see if there was any around the same time, specifically which was August 25th, and there was another product that was updated the same date as the other malicious one for the HBBU10, and this one is also supposed to be a zip download, but when I hovered over the link, sure enough, it's actually another RAR file. Now, interestingly, this is not actually the exact same archive RAR file. It has a different hash when you upload it to VirusTotal. However, it still flags like crazy, and when I looked inside, the only difference I could find at all is that the config.ini file has a different modified date, but it seems like the contents of it are exactly the same as well as everything else, so I'm not sure what the difference is. It's all the same stuff. And if there was any other doubt, the file hash for the EXE is the same exact one in the other files, so yeah, it's the same. I will point out I found another download that was from one day after these on August 25th, but this one seems to be completely different, and even though the file in here is unsigned, and when I upload it to VirusTotal, there's two hits, I think that this is probably a false positive, but I would still probably not trust it at this point until everything is really looked into. Now, back to that Word file I mentioned in the root directory of the archive, I did notice that it had modified times that were about the same as the config file and the original legit EXE, which is probably when they went and renamed it to replace it, so it changed the date. When I opened it up, it was all in Chinese, so I don't understand what all this says. Maybe if someone knows, you can let us know in the comments. But what I did see and notice is that the EXE that appears in the screenshots is exactly the same size as the malicious one that is in these archived folders, not the same size as the other cache one, which is what I believe is the legit one, and that doesn't even show up in these screenshots. So I believe whoever created this Word doc file with these screenshots is the person who created the malicious files. I'm not sure what the rest of these instructions mean. If someone knows, again, you can let us know. I did notice in one of the screenshots, there's some paths which are the same as the ones in the config file. And it looks like those Unicode characters we saw are actually Chinese characters, which now makes sense. And I guess maybe they're used as a placeholder path. I don't know if those were the ones in the original legit EXE, but I'm not sure. Though, like I touched on before, if I had to guess, I would suspect that these instructions would seem to work if you followed them. You know, you ran the malicious one, you got infected, but then it would open up the actual tool, and then these instructions probably did legitimately tell you how to install the update to get rid of any suspicion you might have, because again, if it works afterwards, then you're not going to be suspicious. And unfortunately, that seems to have happened in multiple cases. Here's someone on Tom's Hardware that I found searching for the product name. They said they got the virus flag result, and then they said they installed it and it worked. Here's another post comment on Reddit. Someone's talking about the same product, and unfortunately, they're like, oh, I took a chance on it and installed the update and it worked, and they don't even realize that they got infected, probably. Someone did reply to them and try to warn them. I don't know if they ended up seeing that. Now, as for how this could have happened, how this malware could have ended up on their site, your guess is as good as mine. But in any case, I think Sabrent needs to be doing a thorough investigation of how this happened, because it was not just one product. So it's not just like one product down the line, some malware got injected by some bad actor. It's like, it seems like it's on their site a problem, because it's from multiple different products, unless they all came from the same manufacturer and were provided from that person. I don't know. And for the rest of us, it seems like now even that age-old advice to make sure you only download updates from the official manufacturer's website, even that you have to keep an eye out now. Again, you can always be sure to check for signed executables if it's from a big company. I did make a whole video talking about checking for signed executables. If you want to click that, I'll have it pop out. But one thing, like I touched on before, any file that claims to be a driver and it's unsigned is like nuclear grade red flag, because if you're not aware, on Windows, it will only let you run driver installers and files that are signed. It's like a whole thing. If you try to install a unsigned driver, Windows makes you do like a whole special reboot into like a special mode where you can install unsigned drivers and stuff like that. So anything that even claims to be an unsigned driver is likely not that at all, because if it truly was an unsigned driver, they know that most people are not going to be able to even run that. So yeah, hopefully Sabrent gets those files down, and more importantly, looks into how this happened so it can never happen again. And if there's any other manufacturers out there, you might want to contact them and see what factory gave them these files, and maybe look at it yourself. Because there could be other manufacturers out there who might use that same supplier, and who knows how many are out there. As a consumer, we now have to be very careful. You don't know how many issues are out there. This could not be an isolated case. Anyway, if you want to keep watching, I'll put that link to the other video talking about inspecting and signed files and how to do that right there. So thanks so much for watching. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up. Let me know what you think down in the comments, and have a good one.